Why is this so poor?
Hi everyone! Are you all excited to see some more animals? Super! Awesome! Welcome to our aquatic presentation. I'm excited. I get to introduce you to some more animals. Hi everyone, my name is Brittany. I am your guide. I need your help in creating this live experience today. So throughout our aquatic presentation, I hope you'll join in on the fun as we learn more about these awesome animals and how they thrive in nature. Things off. I want to ask you all a question. When I get to the count of three, can I please have everyone say where you're visiting from? Ready? One, two, three. That is so silly. It is incredibly hard to understand anything you're saying. Today I heard New Mexico, I heard Michigan, I heard Chicago. I'm from Arizona. Now, it's super cool that all of you are visiting here today. I hope that you had a very safe journey this lovely Shark Week. Now, Island, that is Sagu. Joining us on the center island today, we have Cree and Ipo. All right, let's check out the map. So, the water that our animals are swimming in is cold. That's how they like it. Pacific white sea dolphins are from the chilly waters of the North Pacific Ocean, the area highlighted on the screen. Just like us human beings, Pacific white sea dolphins are a kind of mammal. Now, our human bodies were adapted for our mammal life up on land. Pacific white sea dolphins, they're uniquely adapted for their life in the water. So, let's talk about some of the differences between our species. Here's a big one. Dolphins have flippers. Let's focus in on the pectoral flippers to start with, which are the ones right here in front of their chest. If you take a look at the screen, we're zoomed in on Cree and her trainer, Adam. We'll be looking at those pectoral flippers. Now, the pectoral flippers are really important for swimming. They're the ones dolphins use to steer through the water. There is one other super cool fact about pectoral flippers, folks. There's actually a series of bones inside those flippers. And this detail can tell us a lot about the animal's distant past. Let me explain. Everyone do me a favor. Please raise up one of your hands. Okay, so we just brought up the x-ray of a human arm and hand. Take a moment. Do you know where all those bones are located? See if you can find some of them by feeling up to the tips of your fingers. That's the human arm and hand. Next up, this is the x-ray of a dolphin's pectoral flipper. Yeah, isn't that super interesting? We're so similar. We're both tetrapods. Okay, so scientists noticed the similarities and we can use those to estimate millions of years ago, the ancestor of dolphins and whales also used to live up on land. But at some point, dolphins and whales left the land and went to live in the water. All right, next up, let me tell you about their tails. The very back of a dolphin's tail, that flipper is called flukes. Now, folks, there is no muscle, no bone at all inside the flukes. But did you see how the dolphins use them? Paddling up and down through the water. Next up, check out the fin on their back. It's called the dorsal fin. It provides stability, keeping the dolphin upright when they swim fast. And finally, the muscular section right by the flukes, that's the peduncle. It provides the muscular power stroke for forward movement, for super fun activities like tail walks. You have to have a really strong peduncle to be able to do that. The peduncle is what allows the dolphins to be able to jump out of the water, and it's also what allows the dolphins to make super awesome splashes. One of those cool skills. I'd like to compare how human and dolphin jumping are different. For this part, I do need the help of a human volunteer. Is there someone here in the audience that's really good at jumping, that didn't help in the trivia already, and can show me they're interested by sitting calmly while holding their hand up? Tough decision. I only need one person for a couple of seconds. I'm going to go with Star Wars shirt right now. Okay, so in just a moment, I'm going to have the audience help me count down. Super, that was like 5 inches. High five. Thank you so much for your help, Josh. But you can go back to your seat. Audience, give him a big round of applause. That was very nice to see you. Right now, the Olympic record for high jumps is just over 8 feet. Humans, we've only hit that barrier once back in 1993. Okay, so dolphins, they jump super high on a regular basis. Let's take a look at a dolphin jump in action. Here in the middle, let's see. Ooh, coming in from behind, this is Cottrell. Sneaky dolphin coming in with a super high jump. Let's get a measurement on dolphins jumping, please. A Pacific white said a dolphin can leap as high as 20 feet out of the water. Yeah, that's pretty incredible, right? Pacific white said the dolphins are super famous for those acrobatic skills. So let's take a moment and just appreciate the dolphins' impressive aerials.
On land. They do waddle more dramatically than other land animals, and yes, I do it. I can fall back.
Penguins, come downstairs and exit out to the left. Thanks again, everyone.